Hey guys, it's ShadeGrey. Welcome back to Darksiders. Dungeon item! This, my friends, is the Tremor Gauntlet. It's very powerful, but it's very strange to use. It's definitely less effective than the Scythe. And welcome to Heavy Enemy of this dungeon. Now, this is a little weird to be doing right now, considering, well, I just got the Tremor Gauntlet and all. But it's really... The Tremor Gauntlet is not the best item to use in the boss fight... in the, quote, not boss that you just got... introduced to. Why? Because this boss has a lot of close range attacks, it's pretty quick, and it's got that 1-2 punch right there that just makes it annoying to deal with. You're better off using your Chaos Eater than trying to be fancy and use your toy on it. Fortunately, well, that's just my opinion. Some people might have a fine time doing it, but I personally do not. These guys, however, are made to be abused by this gauntlet.
Prompt.
Yes! Now, this is probably the best prompt in the entire game, because you're riding on top of this thing, and you can essentially take out every enemy on the map. And as you can see, if the enemy doesn't weigh more than you do, for some weird reason that's how this works, you can send them flying, but if they're bigger than you, for some reason, it doesn't work. Take the big guy out first, please. Actually, I think I'm just kind of trying to avoid him at the moment to show off the gauntlet's true potential. This weapon is actually fairly good, but I just prefer the Scythe because it's more effective for all-around combat. Tremor Gauntlet's really only effective against enemies that are your size or smaller. Otherwise, it's just not as effective. Alright, now we can take out these guys, friend. Ow. These guys' death may get old, but that, my friend, getting on the back of that thing, cutting its horn off, and then... cutting off its head, that never gets old. Oh, poor. Didn't we just kill you? Screw it. Chaos form. And yes, you do kind of look similar to the big guy right there when you're in chaos form, which admittedly is a little strange, but it's not that confusing, especially when you start running into the red ones. It's just a little weird, I suppose, if you take the form of a demon. I do have to admit, when in combination with the Chaos Breaker, Chaos Eater, the Tremor Gauntlet is an effective weapon. Slamming the enemies back down on the ground for another volley attack is good, and being able to bat those really annoying enemies further away is very useful when you need it to be. Especially since you can kind of charge up this little ground pound attack, and you can send them flying! But again, against big guys, the Tremor Gauntlet is just useless. you'd be better off just using the scythe at all times. Finally. Alright, no more enemies to fight, and we're only 5 minutes into the video. We haven't moved from this room. Jeez. Anyway, you want to move up here, and it's kind of obvious what's in this chest. It's a key for the Beholder. And the Beholder is just on the other side of this room. That's where we came from. We can't actually get back up there, so that's why we had to get a Beholder key. It's kind of an artificial way of locking you in this room, but to be fair, it works. The Tremor Gauntlet has not leveled up as much as I thought it would during that fight, so I'm probably going to be using that for a vast majority of time until I get enough to level 1 to match half the level of the Chaos Eater. Yes, I'm doing it for that too. And this is the only way to go. Unfortunately, you can't use your secondary weapons underwater, so these easy little fish enemies are still going to be food for my Chaos Eater. You can also break the coral down here in order to get a couple more souls. Something I admit that I should have done a little bit better of down here, since I don't upgrade everything to its maximum, but I'm still broken as all hell. Alright, now we're on to this puzzle. It's a little annoying, to be completely honest, but I understand what they're trying to go for here. Now, you want to check all the corridors, because there are chests down here that you will need for a few fights later. I believe there may be one soul chest down here, but I could be wrong, because I believe that was a health chest and a wrath chest, which means a soul chest should be down this hallway right here. Or I cannot go inspect it. Whatever. Okay, here we go. And there's no soul chest. Okay, that's weird. If you're gonna go by threes, go by threes! Okay, but this is the big thing that you're gonna love the Tremor Gauntlet for. You know all those things we've had to push? They just got a lot easier. When you grab a hold of something, you can hold down the Y button to charge up your Tremor Gauntlet. When you do, it sends it flying in the direction that you wanted it to based on the power level of that punch. It's honestly the best way to move around things that are this heavy. Well, that are heavy at all, to be completely honest. These puzzles do kind of disappear later in the game, which I'm kind of sad about, to be completely honest, because they just got, as I said, a hell of a lot easier. And we don't want to do that just yet. We want to fly over to that before we punch it. Just because if we don't, we'll be knocking it to the floor, and that's not a good thing. So, going down. Artifact of the Fallen Legion. Artifact of the Fallen Legion. Yes! Soldier artifact. Soldier will be pleased. Moving on. Alright, back up here. Now that this platform's higher than the one next to it, we can punch our thing over there. Fortunately, we still have to obey the laws of physics. To a degree. Or maybe war's just that strong. And this is why we needed this over here, because we clearly can't jump that high. There we go. I don't know why I was pushing it, I could have easily punched it over there, but whatever! Alright, now, to my knowledge, there's nothing over this way, but I'm going to go check just to make sure, and of course I'm right. So, moving on. Going backwards. There we go. Smash it! More of these apocalyptic insect things. These will just injure you. We've got a couple later that will actually electrocute you. I'll talk more about those when we get there, but yeah, they're way more annoying than these basic enemies right here. But yes, these would be the equivalent to the bats that we saw in the last level. They're kind of the boss's little baby prize things, but they're about as threatening as tissue paper. Yeah, see, I'm just exterminating things left and right, and how do I get over there? Oh, there's a rope. Okay, that makes it fairly obvious. Thanks, game. Snap. These things do give back a lot of health, so don't be afraid to confront them. You'll do more damage to them, as you can clearly see, than they could ever possibly hope to do to you. That is, of course, the room where the Tremor Gauntlet was, so now we're just going in a giant circle, and whoa! Hi! Jeez! Okay, you're pissed off, I get it. If I'm right, you can actually kite these enemies into those giant legs that are coming down. Oh, I'm sorry, were you using that body? Well, you're not anymore. Straight in half. Played me again, she's taunting me by just hanging around and saying, haha, I'm over here. Alright, another annoying little thing these new guys have is that projectile fireball attack. Oh wait, no, that's somebody completely different, my bad, that's the upgrade of the upgrade that we just ran into. Sorry, didn't see that it was a different enemy. Alright, so what am I checking? The guide, apparently. Alright, moving on. Okay, now this is the area we want to be at, but first... Stupid. Oh, I don't want to fall. Get down here and fight me like a bug! And that's why you should have the crossblade equipped at all times. Well, at least at this first part. Now you want to smash this door and- OH GOD! Yes. That's dangerous, and that's an artifact of the Fallen Legion down there, so we'll be going to pick that up. And it's another soldier artifact. We will be rolling in cash just as soon as we see Volgrim again, which should be right after we see Uthane. Now, next! We have the map of the dungeon. Ha, I was right. And actually, we get through most of the dungeon in this part. I just mess up on a couple of puzzles right here. Yeah, this is not the best dungeon for me. I only remember about half the levels in here. But what we want to do is we want to get a train car down over there. That's where we need to go next in order to fight the Griever herself. Now, this is actually a really interesting puzzle, but it's also kind of weird. Essentially, what you have to do is you have to move this train car diagonally to that point over there, only using back and forth motions and that platform that we see. We can't actually move it because that train car is sitting on it over there. And I honestly don't remember how this puzzle is supposed to go. I mean, I know what the end objective is, but I don't remember how to get to said end objective. But this crank that we saw earlier, this is what that is what this controls, essentially. The stoppers will go away, so what you want to do now... And as you can see, if you turn it again, the train car moves over here. So, now that we're back at the starting point, let's completely mess up the puzzle, shall we? If you punch at a full power with your, Tremor Gauntlet, you can completely shoot the train in the direction you want to shoot it. However, you want to make sure that it gets all the way off the track. If it does not, then you're going to run into problems and you won't be able to move the platform from left to right. So make sure it's all the way off before you run all the way up here, otherwise you're going to be wasting your time. The green lights indicate that the platform can be moved. Now, interestingly enough, these two cars do have different weights. This train car right here weighs a lot more than the, I'm sorry, I got it backwards. That car weighs more than this one, for some stupid reason. Yeah, my bad. How was I supposed to know that these cars would have different weights? Now I gotta lightly keep punching this thing. Or else that's gonna keep happening, and we're gonna be here for a while. You know what? Just pull the damn thing. Love tap. Love tap. Love tap. Love tap. Push, push, push. There! Fuck it. Ah. Buck this ride! Anyway... Now we move the train car over here, except that the other train car is exactly where we need this one to be. So, what we need to do in order to fix this... because we need it to be right here, is we have to push this train car back, not to where it originally was, but to, no, we can't, because of all the rubble. Again, I don't remember the puzzles in this area at all. This is like the dungeon I spent the least amount of time in just because I blew through it so fast on the first try, so I didn't bother to memorize any of these puzzles. Alright, so, trying this again. What we want to do is we want to launch the train car all the way to the other side of the track. Then we want to run back up these stairs. God, I wish I had two people doing this. And turn the crank. So the platform goes over here. Then we want to move the train car that was originally on the platform back onto the platform. So that way we can move it to a more suitable area and get the other train car back on it. Tedium at its finest. Okay, back up. Let's adjust to this thing. Okay, and there we go. Once the lights stop flashing, we can move the train car. Twist. Turn. And back. And now... we pull it instead of punching it for some reason. Yeah, thank you, past me. Thank you for listening to me. There, now it's off the track. And now we can put this one on the track. Let's just hope that it goes where we want it to go. So, behind, Falcon Punch! Now we just have to adjust it. Okay, I know I'm extremely strong, but damn. Oh, seriously? Fine. Turn the crank. And now, we can finally leave this room. Grab a hold and punch. Yes. I know. I solved the puzzle correctly. Okay. Now, we can actually move on. But we've only got about, 40 seconds left in the video. So, we will be continuing this dungeon next time, and tomorrow we'll probably be fighting the Griever as well. I'm ShadeGrey, I hope you enjoyed today's part. Oh, it's so satisfying to finally be able to get through all that crap. Now I just have to remember where to go. Oh, that's right. Now that we've finished this side, tomorrow we'll be exploring the other half of this dungeon. You know, that half that we couldn't access because the blue ice was blocking us, and now that we have the Tremor Gauntlet, we can totally get by all that crap. Ah. So yes, we'll be doing that next time. I'm ShadeGrey, and I hope you all have a pleasant day.